Hi everyone, my name's Pete. Welcome to Shooting for Scratch and another in my Swing Bite series of videos in which I take a look at the individual faults in my swing, the problems that they cause, what I'm looking to do to change them with my coach Dan Whitaker, and the hopeful benefits that those changes will bring. Now I'll also try and include some swing drills or routines or thoughts that I'll hope to use in order to get those things ingrained into my swing. So the fault today is the fact that my hands were a little bit too high at the address position. The sole of the club was sitting flat on the ground behind the ball, my arms were a little bit too far from the body, and my left arm a little bit too in line with the shaft of the club. Now, from that position, the problems that can cause are twofold. Now, I'm exaggerating this a little bit. The problem in my own swing wasn't this bad, but for the sake of demonstrating it, with your hands very high at address, it's anatomically difficult to take the club back and actually set the wrists. The only option that you've got, and this is what was contributing to the problem in my swing, is to roll the hands low around, back and behind your body until such point that your wrists have rolled over enough that you can then set them. But by then it's too late because your arms are behind you, the club's behind you, and you can never get into a good position at the top from there. The only other option that you've got is taking your arms down the line and getting very disconnected and not setting your wrists at all really. And that is a double problem for people that are trying to get extra width in their swing, because if their hands are too high at address and they're trying to get extra width on their backswing, then you become very, very disconnected at the top, and that's no good. So the way that I'm looking to change this or address this is from slightly exaggerated high hands position. What I'm looking to do first of all is get myself into a more athletic position, so slightly bent knees, the weight even across my feet but more tending towards the balls of my feet, tension in my hamstrings and my bum, my stomach and my lower back, and then letting the hands come down a little bit lower by allowing the arms to drop more vertically. So previously they were more away from my body, now they're closer to my body. You don't want them any closer than vertical, so you don't want them pointing back towards your body because then the club will be too close to you. But just hanging vertically down is fine. And allowing your hands to drop a little bit. The toe of the club should come up from the mat probably by about 2 millimeters, and there should be a little bit of angle between your left arm and the club shaft. And that then is an ideal position in order to be able to start the wrist set. Now this was a little bit of a light bulb moment for me, a kind of eureka moment, because for the 2 months that Dan has been trying to help me get my wrist set steeper and earlier, I've been struggling with it. And just getting myself into this slightly different position, it's only a matter of sort of an inch or two of the butt of the club just settling down slightly, but from there you're able to set the club up almost immediately and steeply into your takeaway and get into a good position at the top. And so if you're somebody who suffers with either getting disconnected because you're not getting any wrist set at all, or you're somebody like me who takes the club away very low, back and around their body below plane, give it a try. See if lower hands can actually help you get those wrists set better and make a difference in your golf swing. It's really making a massive difference to my consistency. So for some sort of relevance to what you're watching, the last couple of months that I've been working with Dan, the consistency in my game has definitely improved. I'm now taking the left side of the course out of play. My ball striking has become much more consistent. I wouldn't say that my scores are improving particularly, even though I'm not taking part in any handicap qualifying events, but the rounds of golf practice rounds that I am playing, I'm definitely seeing an improvement in my ball striking consistency. And this better wrist set and better sort of body motion through the ball, especially with clearing my left shoulder out of the way as well, that's really helping me with my chipping. And so everything within sort of 60 yards really is starting to have a noticeable improvement. If there's anything you recognise, you can relate to problems in your own swing, please do give it a thumbs up. If you've got any questions or any comments, leave them in the section below. And of course, I'll do my very best to get back to you as soon as I possibly can. Otherwise, please do subscribe. Thank you very much indeed again for watching, and I very much look forward to seeing you in one of my next videos.